Good evening. I'm happy to welcome you to today's class on the construction plant. So we started discussing about transporting plant, where we discussed various, and we were let's continue from the cranes as a transporting plant. Cranes, majorly we are using these to transport materials from lower ground to higher ground. For example, you can able to transport materials from the ground floor up to the 10th floor, depending on the nature of the buildings. So in an exam situation, that you can be asked with an aid of a sketch to explain a different types of cranes. Since we have different types of crane, we have the static crane, we have the lorry mounted cranes, then again you can have truck mounted cranes, and again you can have self-propelled cranes as a types of cranes. So in this one, let's start by the static crane. It means this crane has to be placed somewhere, so it has to remain in that place for the entire life of the constructions. If this construction is supposed to take 2 years, then this our crane, we have to mount it in this place where it has to serve for the entire construction life. But when talk about the mobile cranes, it means we can use these cranes at only the time of need, since after the finishing of the job, it can be used for another job, and we only come back when there is need. So when you are asked in an exam situation to explain, to give an aid of a static cranes, this is what you are required to draw. But when drawing any of the plant, the major thing that you have to take into considerations are the parts of the cranes and how these machines work. For example, this is a static crane. It has a jib. Again, it has a counter jib. Then it has a counterweight. Then we have the slewing ring. Then we have the tower. Then we say the tower remains in static while the counter jib will rotate or screw. Then another thing we have to indicate the ballast. The functions of the ballast is to enable it to have enough weight. It enables it to have good base so that it cannot move in and out when transporting any of materials. Then the working principles of these machines, this way you can say, the static cranes has a lower pivot that operates from downwards to upwards. They again say high pivot cranes can be operated or from a fixed position or from a rail mounted crane. Let's look at another type of cranes, which is the lorry mounted cranes or the mobile cranes. The mobile cranes has a lower pivot cranes. Then again, it has 2 to 4 face of rope. We have the top boom as indicated in the notes. You'll see these parts. Then again, we have it should also have operating curve, where this operating curve is where the operator will have to sit while operating these machines. Then we have the bottom boom sections, where the bottom boom sections is positioned along the jib. Then we have the chassis, which is fixed with a resistor wheel to control the tire directions or deflections. Then another thing, it has to the engine power unit, which moves around 360 degrees. Then we have the boom section rope, as you can see in the diagram. Then we have the pedant rope, as also indicated. Then another specifications of this, we say the main boom has a length of 38 millimeters maximum. Then we say it can lift a capacity of 24 tons per boom length. Then say again it has a turn of 3 to 4 turns of the radius, which also moves on a free wheels. Then again is for the downwards, it has 6 to 9 turns. It means if it wants to transport materials from the upward taking to downwards, then it can carry a higher weight than compared when we are transporting the materials from the lower ground to a upper ground. Then another types of cranes, we have the lorry mounted lattice jib cranes. In these cranes, as indicated in the diagram, so these are the only parts that you have to take care when given a task to draw these types of crane in an exam situations. So you have to indicate these parts. We have the jib suspension, then we have again the diesel engine lorry, then we have the pendant or laughing rope, then we have the main hoist rope. Another part that we have the jib block, then we have the diesel engine, as I've said. Another type of cranes that we have is the truck mounted or the crawler crane. The truck mounted or the crawler cranes. So it has these parts. We have the the jib suspension ropes. We have the diesel powered crawler unit with 360 degree slewing capacity. Then we have the hoist block. Again, we have the multiple folds of rope. Then we have the flying jib attachment. Then, and again, we have the pendant looping rope. So the last one, we have the lattice cross beam or the gang rope, the gang crane. As in the, I've indicated in the notes, we have this part. We have the driving cup. Then we have the hoist crane. Then we have the lattice, which is a frame, the distance between one frame to another, the, which has a span frame of 20 meters maximum and the height of 25 meters high. The maximum travel time of this crane is 50 meters per unit per minute, which is also powered by bogies. Then we have another types of crane as the mast crane. The master crane. In this type of crane, as indicated, we have the winch which encloses the electric motor. Then we have the slewing platform chassis. Again, we have the slewing ring and we have the mast stout. The more of these cranes we'll discuss in the next class, which of course after completing this that we'll be going to the next topic, which will be drilling and blasting equipments. So from there I request that I leave the class and let's meet in the next class. Thank you.